In this Q&A video made in association with Schneider Electric, we're going to answer the question, why do some RCBOs have an earth connection, whereas some don't? Now this video relates to the beautiful Acti9 boards from Schneider, which have the really clever feature of not requiring a fly lead for the connection to neutral or earth for their RCBOs, which just makes life so much easier and frees up so much space in their distribution boards. However, you may have noticed that the RCBOs mentioned in the video that this question relates to have a connection for the functional earth. But why? What does that functional earth connection do, and why do some RCBOs not have this feature? Well, first of all, let's remind ourselves what an RCD does. In its simplest form, it watches the current in the line conductor, and it watches the current back down the neutral. If the currents are the same, the RCD is happy. If the current is smaller in the neutral, then it knows that there is current leaking somewhere it shouldn't, like through a person. And then it will disconnect the attached circuit when that happens. And for most instances, this is perfectly safe. If, however, you lose the neutral connection to your property, especially in a TNCS system, it's possible that someone could get a shock and the RCD would not disconnect. Also, if the supply voltage to the property dropped, someone could get a shock and the RCD would not disconnect. Now, it's fair to say that this combination of circumstances happening is fairly low. You'd need to be pretty unlucky to have a loss of neutral and be in contact with an exposed conductive part at the same time and a good connection to earth also. However, bear in mind that the risk of this happening is high enough that we provide protection against it with our EV charging outlets when we install those. However, RCBOs which have this earth connection can still operate when the voltage drops or if the neutral connection to the installation goes down. Now, this earth connection is not there to connect a piece of metalwork to the earthing system in the property, but rather this earthing connection is there to make the device work properly, and it's therefore called a functional earth, as it is allowing the RCD to operate correctly. And that's the reason that it's not the traditional green and yellow that you associate with normal earth type connections. Now, just to reassure you that an RCBO with no functional earth connection is not intrinsically unsafe and will continue to provide protection in almost every case of shock to earth. However, if you do install an RCBO with a functional earth, it must be connected up, as the device has been tested with this connection made and it may not be reliable without the functional earth. The fly lead can be extended and cut shorter if necessary. Or, to save yourself time, use a product such as the Acti9 from Schneider with plug-in neutral, which includes that functional earth connection without a separate fly lead. As always, we'd like to hear your comments on this subject. Do you install RCD protection with or without functional earths? Do you think we'll continue to see them being used, or will the rise of type A, F and B RCDs see them phased out? Please leave any comments and questions below, and all that remains in this video is to say thank you very much for watching.